Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's how-to video, I'm going to teach you how to get your fish to eat whatever you want them to by tricking them into doing it. More specifically, we're going to talk about how to get predator fish off of feeder fish. So why would you want to get your fish off of feeder fish in the first place? Well, simply put, feeder fish can be both dangerous as well as not even be nutritionally valuable. So how can they be dangerous? Well, feeder fish are actually bred on the basis of quantity and not quality, meaning that they are bred as in mass numbers and as quickly and as fast as possible. They're not bred to create a beautiful and well-formed and high-quality fish, meaning that they're fed a very poor diet and bred in numbers just to rush them out the door to be fed to something else. So obviously they're not going to be high in nutritional value. I should also mention that they're kept in such high density numbers that pathogens and parasites are prolific in feeder fish. Whatever your feeder fish has and you give it to your regular fish, it's going to contract it. So that's what makes them nutritionally deficient as well as dangerous. Now a lot of you might even say, well, I quarantine my fish, and most of you probably do not. And those that do probably don't do it near as long enough. By the time you quarantined a feeder fish long enough and to make sure it's safe for you to feed to your regular fish and gut load it to make sure that it is nutritionally valuable, it's no longer really worth the effort. All you're really doing is fulfilling your own desire to see one fish eat another fish. When it comes to diet, in my opinion, it's the one thing that you should have full control over. Your fish depend on you to provide not only great water quality, but a meaningful diet. So how are we going to get them to do this? Well, there's a number of things that I like to do in order to trigger my fish onto new foods and or get them off of live foods. The first thing that I like to do is stop feeding it. If it's not accepting what I'm giving it, I'm just not going to give it anything until it works its appetite up. And within a few days, the fish will typically work its appetite enough and get hungry enough to accept whatever you're offering. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. For the most part, it works. If that's not working for me, I make sure that I'm doing big water changes while doing it and ensuring that the water is not only clean, but I'm stripping out any detritus or anything that might interfere with their taste senses. So when I do add new food, they can actually taste it going into the water. And they know that this is a food. I also bump the temperature up by a couple of degrees, and this helps speed the fish's metabolism up slightly. Now, if just a combination of those two things is, again, usually enough to get the fish to take whatever you want it to eat. But again, sometimes it's not. So what I tend to go to, if the fish isn't eating the flakes or the pellets that I'm trying to get it to take, I'll go to some raw foods, like strips of fish or shrimp. Now, shrimp is my personal favorite because there's a lot more you can do with it when you're triggering your fish to try to get them to eat something else. You want to make sure that it's not pre-cooked. Pre-cooked offers the fish a different texture, and most fish don't like it because it's a little bit more rubbery and harder to chew for them. You want it to be as fresh as possible. So essentially, I buy it frozen and never cooked. Then all I have to do is thaw it out. Now, a lot of the times, this is tempting enough for the fish just to eat it. And sometimes it's not. The only thing you really want to do when you're just dropping it in the tank is to make sure that you cut it up in pieces that the fish can actually eat it in, meaning that they can fit it inside their mouths. So what if that doesn't work? You've done your water changes, you've bumped the temperature up, you've starved them, you've gave them fresh foods. Well, there's still an old trick that we can use. What you'll want to do is grab some thread, just some sewing thread, and you'll want to take one of those shrimp and you want to cut it lengthwise and or cut it into long strips, because this is going to simulate other animals in the water. Other fish are not just chunks of fish, they're usually long slivers, and that's what attracts predators like this. You'll want to take that sliver and tie it to the end of the string. Now, you don't want to tie it so tight that the fish has to tug on it. You want to tie it in a knot that can either let go immediately and or that it just simply lets go if there's any pressure put on it. And then you literally want to fish it into your fish. This triggers their instincts to attack it. Sometimes they'll just mouth it and spit it back out. At other times, they just swallow it. Now, sometimes if you cut shrimp lengthwise, it will spiral through the water. And if that happens, the fish goes nuts and they attack it every time. Now, what if your fish still isn't taking it? Well, again, there's still more we can do. See, sometimes when you put something into your tank, your fish might not take it because of you. Maybe you have a bright colored shirt on, maybe it's bright yellow, or maybe it's just bright white. Whatever the case may be, What you want to do is ensure that the fish has a subdued environment so that it feels comfortable in eating whatever you're offering it. So my suggestion would be to shut off all the ambient lights and subdue the regular lighting as much as you can. Also ensure that you're wearing dark clothing. So when you do approach the tank, you do so slowly and you're not this big pylon that's scaring the fish. The fish might also see the string, which is unlikely. However, you can use string that is the same color as your background, so it blends in more. Or my suggestion would be, when all else fails, use a red string. Now, when it comes to fish, it's commonly known that for the most part, they can't actually see the color red. Now, that's debatable on how deep the water is and the species of fish, and I'm not sure if I personally believe it, but it's worth a shot. So you got the fish to eat the shrimp off of the rope. Congratulations, we're not done yet. That's all. The only purpose of guiding the string and the shrimp or whatever fish or food you're feeding it is to make sure that it's eating something other than something live. And putting it on that string is simulating a live fish. Now that it's accepting dead fish, we can go ahead and see if it'll accept it if we drop it in the tank, meaning that it's just going to float to the bottom of the tank or sit on the top or however it's going to act. We want to see if it will eat it without our help or without coaxing it. If it does, great. If it doesn't, give it a couple of hours and maybe he'll eat it when you're not around. If not, you're definitely going to want to remove it and try again the next day. Now, putting it on the string is something you might have to do for a few days or even a couple of weeks just to get it eating something other than live. But eventually, it will take the food that's dropping to the bottom or dropping throughout the tank. It will see it as food. And when that happens, here's what you do. You want to take the shrimp or the fish and you want to stuff a pellet in it. Sometimes you just slice a little hole and stick a pellet in it and or whatever other type of food you're trying to give it. For the most part, a lot of big fish take pellets. And because the fish is already feeding off of food that's falling to the bottom and or whatever you're dropping in, it's going to take the shrimp with the pellet stuffed into it, no problem. And what we're doing is tricking the fish into eating the food that we really want it to eat. They're not going to be able to taste that pellet, but they're going to get the nutritional benefits of it. Now you can stop right there and that's their diet from now on is something you could potentially do. However, a lot of you just want to get your fish onto pellets. So what I suggest doing is slowly limiting the size of the shrimp or the fish or whatever you're stuffing the pellet into by a little bit every day. Meaning one day it's a full size, a couple days later it's maybe a half a centimeter, a centimeter shorter and shorter and shorter until you're basically left with just the pellet. And by that time, the fish will just eat the pellets, no problem. So that's how I get my bigger free-swimming fish to take foods that I really want them to eat. So if this video wasn't for you, check back next Sunday because I will have a new how-to video like I do every week. If you can't wait till Sunday, I also make Thursday videos where I discuss an aquarium topic of the week, which is basically just a random topic that I think you guys might be interested in hearing about. I'm also on Facebook, so if you get a minute, find me on there. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next week for a video just like this one.